contamination in the Japanese waters, oil soars, gold soars, and yes, silver, $39, $39. Hey, that was my silver futurist impersonation. I love that channel, by the way. Check it out. All right, it's April 5th, 2011. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. Oil, gold, silver, it's all up. Gold hit all-time high of $1,450 per ounce today. Silver hit $39.25 and settled at $39.12 per ounce. That's a 1.8% increase. Corn increased 15% over the last 4 days because of a U.S. report that their inventories for corn were actually pretty low as of March 1st. And oil, the WTI, is now at $108.34. Oil is going up, and I think it's going to hit that $129 mark. And there's other reports that it may go up even more. What do you think? Okay, and how is this really going to affect the economy if oil keeps going up and up and up? You know, Congress made a dent. They're calling it a major dent in the healthcare bill, Obama's healthcare bill. But it's not really that major because it doesn't fundamentally change the bill. And that's why the support was 87-12 in the Senate. It was bipartisan, obviously. But what it did change was the healthcare laws paperwork for small businesses and paperwork requirements for small businesses, and also rewrote some of the benefit, the health exchange subsidies and how they're really paid and all that. So it made some minor changes, but the bill is still there. Do you think it's actually going to be removed sometime soon? I don't think so. I think the beef of the bill is going to be here pretty much for good. Okay, Geithner, the same Geithner who didn't know he had to pay employment taxes, but now he's the Treasury Secretary, and yeah, can you imagine running the IRS and you don't know you had to pay taxes? Anyway, Geithner, he's now saying the U.S. is going to hit its debt ceiling on May 16th or sometime around it. The Treasury Department is now projecting that the $14.3 trillion debt limit, which is something that's set up by Congress, saying that, you know, by statute you cannot have a greater debt than this amount right here. The $14.3 trillion with a T is going to be reached sometime between April 15th and May 31st. Now, as of last Friday, the Treasury borrowing stood just $35 billion from the ceiling. I think they're going to keep raising the ceiling and raising the ceiling until the ceiling comes falling down on their heads. That's what I think. March Madness. And by March Madness, I'm not talking about Butler versus UConn. Although, I don't think anybody should be the national champion in basketball in anywhere if they're shooting under 40%. But hell, Butler had under 20%. I'm glad I don't watch college sports anymore. Anyway, March Madness, real March Madness. The United States government spent more than eight times its monthly revenue. It grossed $194 billion in tax revenue, and it paid out $65.8 billion in the month of March. Get ready for it. But the Treasury paid a net of $1.0528 trillion in federal expenses. I think that's going to have a lot to do with the whole ceiling falling on their heads. U.S. service sector, the ISM non-manufacturing index fell to 57.3. Now, keep in mind that if it's 50 or higher, it means there's actual growth. Now, it went from 59.7 in February to 57.3 in March. So obviously there's still growth, but the growth is decreasing, and it was unexpected. I'm sick of that word. sick of it. Economists expected it to be pretty much flat. Okay, now it looks like April Gallup, who is a military specialist, apparently. I found this article on Yahoo News, so you guys tell me what you think about it. April is suing the Bush administration. It's a case of Gallup versus Cheney, Rumsfeld, and Myers. It's going to be heard by the United States Court of Appeals for the Second Circuit. Now, Gallup believes that the Bush administration conspired to destroy the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center and World Trade Center 7 by organizing pre-placed explosives to be detonated after the planes hit the buildings. Well, Of course, our plane didn't hit Building 7 at all. What do you think about this? I'm having a hard time finding a lot of information about this because I keep searching. I'm not really coming up with anything. Anyway, I've been giving Obama a hard time about his birth certificate records and stuff, but looks like Mike Huckabee's gubernatorial records are missing. He was governor of Arkansas for 12 years, and it looks like the records are unavailable. The computer hard drives that once contained them have been erased and physically destroyed. Okay. Well, at least according to this source right here, I'll let you guys look it up. It's at politicalwire.com. That's what's reporting. Japan finds toxic fish as ocean radiation soars at 7.5 million times the legal limit. Okay, that's incredible. I'm talking about radioactive iodide 131. Question of the day. If you could only have one of the following, which one would you choose? Love, fame, wealth, or power? It seems like love and fame creates more problems than they actually solve. With power, you can actually acquire wealth. So it seems like power would be the logical choice. What do you think? And what do you think Congress is going to do about the debt ceiling? And what do you think they should do about it? Thanks, guys, for listening. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.